Farhan, I will take you to another surah in the Quran, because as we said, Amrullah in Surah Nuh, yes, Amrullah come and cover the whole earth as what is happening now. But in many other cases, Amrullah, no, it come limited to a group of people, to one nation, like what happened with Qawm Hud, Qawm Lut, Qawm Saleh, Qawm Shu'aib, right?
Right.
Qawm Fir'aun. It was not the punishment does not cover the earth.
Right.
It was a limited people, limited tribe, limited city, a limited nation, and that's it. But we have to look for other kind of similarity, Farhan. That is the main purpose of this study. I am not making this study to tell you that, oh, what is going on is Amrullah or Qadarullah. So it follows the natural laws of Allah, or no, that is something beyond that natural law, that's something more serious. It is not my duty to say that, but I put in front of you the fact, the knowledge, through which when you study, you can then by yourself decide for yourself if this Amrullah or Qadarullah. And based on your own decision, you will decide how you will react to what is going on.
Right.
If you decide that no, that is Amrullah, you will react in one way. But if you decide that no, that is natural causes, that is a qadar, like any aqdar, then you will react with a total different approach and attitude.
Right.
And based on that, you will face your destination then.
Right.
Then, okay, now we come to Surah Hud. That is why we make this study. In Surah Hud, verse number 64, in Surah Hud, Saleh, this ayah is talking about Saleh alayhi salam, Prophet Saleh. Prophet Saleh is telling his people what? وَيَا قَوْمِ هَذِهِ نَاقَةُ اللَّهِ. That is the camel of Allah.
Right.
لَكُمْ ayah, it is a miracle. فَذَرُوهَا تَأْكُلْ فِي أَرْضِ اللَّهِ. Just leave it. Go in the land of Allah. وَلَا تَمَسُّهَا بِالسُّوءِ. Don't kill it. Don't assassinate it. Don't harm it. وَلَا تَمَسُّهَا بِالسُّوءِ. فَيَأْخُذَكُمْ عَذَابٌ قَرِيبٌ. Otherwise, if you do that, then a tough punishment, and it will be soon.
Right.
A soon punishment will come to you. We here can ask a question. Naqatullah, is it just the camel, or it is any divine figure belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?
Any divine figure, whatever. Any
divine figure belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right?
Yes.
That is what Allah did with Abraha when he tried to destroy, demolish the Kaaba.
Yes.
What Allah did with him. Imam Ali al-Hadi alayhi salam, when the Khalifa forced him to go in a parade and to witness a parade for the Mutawakkil at his time, and he forced him, one of his companion here, the Imam saying, Wallahi ma fasilu naqata salih ba'azza ala Allahi minni. He listened to him saying that the camel of Saleh is not more dearer to Allah than me. This guy violate my respect, my secrecy. He violate my imamatship. So the one of the people who beside the imam and listen to him, then he told the people, listen, if the imam said that, this means that this mutawakkil will not stay more than 3 days and his kingdom will done. And yes, just after 3 days, his son, the Mutawakkil son, Mustansir, jump upon him and kill his father and take the Khilafat. So this guy went to the Imam and told him, how that happened? He told him, because the ayah said, فَتَمَتَّعُ فِيدَكُمْ ثَلَاثَةَ أَيَّامٍ. The camel of Allah, of Saleh, is not dearer to Allah than me. So when I said that, I mean that just 3 days, as was happened. And this, the Khilafat of this tyrant will end. So from that, we knew that the naqa here, the camel, is not just the camel. It represents any divine character.
Mm.
And the last time you talk about the pure self, which will get killed in Iraq, right?
Yes.
You remember when you refer to that?
Yes.
And look here, what a يَا قَوْمِ هَذِهِ نَاقَةُ اللَّهِ لَكُمْ آيَةٌ فَذَرُوهَا تَأْكُلْ فِي أَرْضِ اللَّهِ. Why you have to assassinate this character? Why you have to kill this character? Why you have to do that? وَلَتَمَسُّوهَا بِسُوءٍ فَيَأْخُذَكُمْ عَذَابٌ قَرِيبٌ. If you do, if you did that, if you kill that person or that creation for Allah, then a soon punishment will fall upon it.
Mm.
And I restarted.
Yes.
Then Allah said, فَعَقَرُوهَا. Then they violate the secrecy of Allah, the hurma of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَعَقَرُوهَا. فَقَالَ what? Listen to this, يا فرحان. فَقَالَ تَمَتَّعُوا فِي دَارِكُمْ ثَلَاثَةِ أَيَّامٍ ذَلِكَ وَعْدٌ غَيْرُ مَكْذُوبٍ. Allah said, okay, just go to your homes. Stay home. Stay home. تَمَتَّعُوا فِي دَارِكُمْ. Enjoy your life in your homes. Work from homes. تَمَتَّعُوا فِي دَارِكُمْ ثَلَاثَةُ أَيَّامٍ. 3 days. ذَلِكَ وَعْدٌ غَيْرُ مَكْزُوبٍ. That is a punishment, a promise Allah make. It is not a lie. That is wa'd ghayr makdhub. That is a reality will come. The punishment will come to you. فَلَمَّا جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا. Listen to the word أَمْرُنَا again. أَمْرُ اللَّهِ. أَمْرُ اللَّهِ again, يا عمران. Right, يا فرحان. That is again Allah using أَمْرُنَا.
Oh.
يَا بُنَيَّ لَا عَاصِمَ الْيَوْمَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ. That is the whole meaning of the discussion. That
right.
Differentiate between Amrullah and the Qadarullah. فَلَمَّا جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا. Oh, now that is the Amr of Allah. Even it didn't cover the whole earth. It is regarding some group of people only, but still it has Amr. فَلَمَّا جَاءَ أَمْرُنَا نَجَّيْنَا صَالِحًا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ. We saved Salih and وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ. He didn't say الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِهِ. And the big difference. You can tell me also what is the difference. Big difference between amanu ma'ahu and amanu bihi. Amanu ma'ahu means they believe him and they follow his shari'at. They follow his sunnah. They follow his footsteps. But amanu bihi, they believe in him, but not necessarily they carry out his instructions. That's a big difference, because somebody asked me, so, okay, if that is the case, we see some big ulama died in this. We see Shia died in this. What is going on here?
Right.
Allah is saying, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ. Those who believe in him and follow his footsteps, carry out his instructions. آمَنُوا مَعَهُ, not آمَنُوا بِهِ. بِرَحْمَةٍ مِنَّا. Again, يَا بُنَيَّ اِرْكَبْ مَعَنَا. لا عاصم اليوم من أمر الله إلا من رحم. And again Allah repeating, والذين آمنوا معه برحمة منا. Only the mercy of Allah can save you. Only. We have to keep that in mind. If we didn't believe in that, if we believe that staying home and washing our hands 10 million times and using the mask and the alcohol, and if we believe that that will protect us, it's too bad. Yeah. Only the rahmah of Allah can protect us.
Yes.
Do whatever you want. I didn't tell you that, okay, go and then. No. Do whatever. But your true belief should be what? In the rahmah of Allah, not in these things. Exactly like when you go to a doctor. You believe that Allah will cure you. But you have to go to the doctor and use the medication. But your true belief that not the doctor, not the medication, cure you, that is the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the big difference.
Great.
Big difference. بِرَحْمَةٍ مِّنْ يَوْمٍ خِزْيَ يَوْمَ إِذٍ. and from the humiliation from that day, the day of the punishment. It was a humiliating day. Not like now, see, if somebody, you know that, oh, he has a coronavirus, it's become humiliated, it become humiliation, right? That people start to distance himself from him and from everything related to him, right? That is khizy. خزي يوم إذ إن ربك هو القوي العزيز وأخذ الذين ظلموا الصيحة. Then Allah sent upon them the supersonic call from Allah. فأصبحوا في ديارهم. They died inside their home. أصبحوا في ديارهم جاسمين. كأن لم يغنوا فيها. As no civilization was never exist. As nothing humanity has achieved before. ألا إن ثمود كفروا ربهم ألا بعدا لثمود. That is why I keep telling you guys many times that every civilization reaches a climax, and when it reaches its climax, it carries its tyranny. Then Allah destroys his civilization. And the scale of civilization returned back to zero again. And the humanity started from the beginning again. That is, if you stand in front of the pyramids, you can't imagine how those people have such a technology. How at that time? How? How come? And what happened to all this civilization? How it suddenly disappeared? Suddenly. What about the Atlantic city, the Atlantic, what they called it, the Atlantis?
Yes.
Which did totally disappear from the face of Earth. What happened? How come? And all this civilization disappear, and the humanity start from again. I am not telling that, this is what will happen. No, I just review some of the Quranic facts in front of you, which can help you to decide for yourself. Because I noticed that in the last few years, I see even ulama, scholars, when you come to talk to them about, Imam al-Zaman, so how Imam al-Zaman will come with the sword and horses, and how come while now we have rockets? No. He tell you like that. No, the Imam come with the smart bombs. He come with the missiles. He will come with technology. He never believed that this technology on the face of Earth, it will come to an end. And it will maybe return back to the time of candles. And the light is fired again. And we start to ride camels again. And look what's happening now. Where is all this technology? It stand totally powerless, incapable in front of an unliving creation. Even though, I believe that it is a living organism. It is not an unliving. Of course, it is a living. But even based on their consideration that it is an unliving, how come all this technology stand still, stand powerless in front of this virus?